WFSB. This is an Eyewitness News update.
Everyone, it is Friday, March 10th. Thanks for joining us. I'm Nicole Nalepa. We, of course, have all of your top stories to get you started. But first, we have to talk about the weather because that's the big headline. Let's head right over to meteorologist Scot Haney, who is following that early warning weather alert. We have some snow coming our way, right, Scot?
Yeah, a little bit tonight, Nicole, through tomorrow morning. Unfortunately, it's going to be a messy night and very early tomorrow morning. Third shifters are going to have to play accordingly. Let's talk about the parade tomorrow. 9, 10 o'clock, the precipitation should still be coming down, although it's going to get lighter and sporadic. We're still expecting maybe a couple of raindrops, maybe a couple of snowflakes during the kickoff for the parade. And then by 11 noon, 1 o'clock, we're just under mostly cloudy skies. And it's going to be a cool, kind of a raw day tomorrow. So dress accordingly. Hey, don't forget, we flip the clocks ahead an hour before we go to bed. Saturday night. Sun is up at 6:10 tomorrow, sets at 5:52. Sunday, sun is up at 7:08, sets at 6:54. And don't forget, change those smoke detector batteries. That would be greatly appreciated. All right, we are in alert mode tonight through tomorrow morning. Steady snow. The heaviest will be in western Connecticut, lighter amounts in eastern Connecticut, but it will be plowable. Particularly in northwest and southwest Connecticut, the slickest spots will be occurring during tomorrow morning early. That's alert number one. Then we need to talk about alert number two. This one will be Monday into Tuesday. A long duration storm is going to be moving in. Classic nor'easter, wind, rain, snow, just a mess. And where it does snow, it could be a lot of snow. So we'll keep you posted on that. In the meantime, winter weather advisory goes into effect for 6 p.m. this evening through 10 a.m. tomorrow. And that is because we're expecting 1 to 3 inches of snow in parts of northeast, southeast, central Connecticut, 3 to 5, maybe a locally higher amount in parts of northwest and southwest by tomorrow morning. In the meantime, our Doppler scans the state dry, visibility good, no fog to greet us this morning, and watch the temperatures climbing into the mid-40s. By later on this afternoon. So that's good. That's pretty close to normal, but we'll be under mostly cloudy skies. Kids, parents, you'll be outside for recess during the day today. Temperatures topping out in the low 40s. There is Mystic, our eye cam there. Things looking beautiful with a gentle breeze, but look at that skyline in Mystic. Temperatures gained a little bit since we went on the air earlier this morning. We're in the upper 20s right now, 30 in Waterbury, 34 in New Haven, Chester 34. Typical overnight low is about 26. That's exactly where we were. Now, we're pretty much down from where we were 24 hours ago, anywhere from 4 to 5 degrees, so that's a bit unfortunate. But the good news is not a whole lot of wind out there, with the exception of the shoreline, 6 to 12 miles an hour sustained. Here's the satellite and radar. The clouds are certainly on the increase. You can see the storm system ganging up on us from the south and west, north and west, and that's going to be making a run towards us. So here's early warning futurecast, tomorrow's weather today. Partial sunshine still at noon and then mostly cloudy skies for the latter part of the day. Tonight, this is 9 o'clock, some rain in the Connecticut River Valley, maybe a little mixing and snow for northwest Connecticut. And then snow takes over tonight through very early tomorrow morning. This is 7 a.m. and then it starts to break down a little bit, hopefully ending just in time for the St. Patrick's Day parade. All right, let's talk about the temperatures today. 40 to 45, clouds on the increase, a calmer wind. And then your 7-day forecast includes the snow tomorrow morning, partial clearing late in the day. Sunday looks good. And then Monday into Tuesday, another mess. That is a classic nor'easter getting ready to roll into the state with winds, several different types of precipitation, just a nasty time period, Monday late through the day on Tuesday. We'll keep you posted on that. 7:04 is now the time. Nicole, we'll send it back to you.
All right, thanks, Scot. There you go. Scan that weather app. And thanks for all that information, Scot. Now at 7:04, we turn to developing news in Hartford, where we know that police are searching right now for a suspect in connection to a deadly shooting that killed a man in his 20s. And our Pinpoint News Tracker takes us to the intersection of Albany Ave and Woodland Street. Officials tell us that 28-year-old Carl Patterson Jr. was shot multiple times in his car on Baltimore Street yesterday, right around 2:30 in the afternoon. He then drove on Albany Street, where police say he crashed his car. Patterson was taken to a hospital where we learned he died. So if you know anything about the shooting, Hartford police want to hear from you. We are also following developing news right now in Hamden, where a section of Dixwell Avenue has reopened this morning after the road was shut down for several hours due to a police investigation. So the portion of the road that was shut down was right between Putnam Ave and Church Street. Now, at this point, police have not released any more details, but we continue to ask them questions. As soon as they answer, we will be sure to pass that along to you. Over in Shelton, two parents have been arrested after police say they allowed underage kids to drink at their home prior to a deadly fight last May. Paul and Susanna Leifer are both charged with permitting minors to possess alcohol. Susanna Leifer is also charged with reckless endangerment after admitting to interacting with some of the teens. Police say some of those teens then moved on to another party after drinking heavily, and that's where Raul Valle stabbed four teens, including 17-year-old Jimmy McGrath, who was killed. The couple was released on a promise to appear in court next month. And police in New London are still searching for a suspect or suspects who fired guns right near the New London High School multi-magnet campus. So the call came in late yesterday morning, but when officers got there, they were unable to locate anyone who they believe is responsible. The nearby school was put into a temporary lockdown just as a safety precaution. And now to Norwalk, where police have arrested a bank robbery suspect who they say pulled off quite the heist. Investigators tell us that yesterday afternoon, Terrence Burden entered the First County Bank on Connecticut Avenue wearing a mask and a hat. Bank staff members say that he demanded money and left with an undisclosed amount of cash. Officers tell us that they were able to track down Burden pretty quickly and peacefully. He's currently locked up right now on a $150,000 bond and will face a judge next week. And police in Naugatuck need your help in identifying a man who wrecked property at a local liquor store. So the suspect, who you are about to see on your screen, is accused of entering Big Liquor right on New Haven Road and damaging 12 packs of beer. Police say the suspect was last seen wearing a red jacket and left the area in a blue Ford Fusion with New York plates. Anyone with any information is asked to call police in Naugatuck. And a new bankruptcy plan is being discussed right now that could pay conspiracy theorist Alex Jones a salary of more than $500,000 a year. His media company proposed a plan saying that it would leave more than $77 million a year, that is, to pay off creditors, including relatives of Sandy Hook shooting victims. The families won nearly $1.5 billion in lawsuits last year against the InfoWars host after he called the Newtown shooting a hoax. And happening tonight in Milford, music legend Mark Wood will be performing a concert right alongside students to wrap up his two-day workshop. Wood has played on some of the world's biggest stages with even bigger names from the Trans-Siberian Orchestra to Celine Dion. This workshop is part of his latest tour to revitalize music programs around the country. Unfortunately, the concert for tonight is already sold out. Also happening today in West Hartford, a group of state lawmakers will be working as servers for the breakfast rush at Blue Plate Kitchen, that is. They say they are doing this to show the struggles of restaurant workers who have an hourly pay that's lower than the minimum wage because they get tips. Now, this effort is all in support of a bill that's making the rounds right now at the State House, which would get rid of that lower pay rate and would require all employers to pay at least the state minimum wage. And tonight at 6:30, UConn men's basketball will be taking on Marquette in the semifinals of the Big East tournament. And this comes after a win yesterday over Providence with a final score of 73-66. Thank you so much for tuning in to Eyewitness News on this Friday. Remember, you can get news and weather updates anytime on the Channel 3 app. Have a great day, everyone. A great weekend. Be healthy, stay positive, and also be weather aware. Get that Channel 3 app handy. See you Monday.